Hey folks, it's Lauren from Snowy's here with the Coleman Aurora C0 CozyFoot Sleeping Bag. It's a soft and comfortable, easy care sleeping bag. It's affordable and it's designed by women for women. So the sleeping bag itself weighs just under 3 kilos. Its packed size is about 45 centimeters long by about 26 centimeters in diameter. Now, when you do get it, it will come rolled, as you can see in the top here. And that is a factory compressed rolling. But on the side of the bag, you'll see we have this white plasticky material here, like the instructions say, can get torn off. It's just a matter of sliding your fingers under either end and just ripping that off. And then what that will do is release this excess amount of storage bag material that we have here that's been bunched up for storage and freight purposes. And that will make it a lot easier for you to get your sleeping bag back in the bag. So moving on to the actual bag itself, when it is laid out flat, it measures 194 centimeters long by about 84 centimeters wide. The materials on the bag are the same for the inside and the outside. It's a nice sort of soft feel brushed polyester. And the lining in the bag, or the fill in the bag, is a hollow fiber. It's like a synthetic hollow fiber. And there's 360 GSM or gram square meter of insulation in the bag. Now, the bag itself, as you might suggest by the name, CO, is around about a 0 degree comfort temp rating. This bag hasn't been EN tested like some of your higher technical bags, so that is really a much of a guide. We'd probably recommend it to be great for temperatures sort of around about that 5 degree mark in real life, but it is rated as a C0, or comfort rating of a 0 bag. So some of the features of the bag is, as you can see here, this small internal pocket. It's probably only large enough to stick a mobile phone and potentially keys, but I don't know if you'd want to be tucking your keys in your sleeping bag. We've also got this nice soft buffer or draft collar that goes around the top of the sleeping bag like so. And having that bit of extra collar there, I guess, can help stop the cold air sort of getting in. It makes it all nice and snuggly around your body. Down the end here, in this section that's a slightly different colour, is the CozyFoot technology. As you can see, it's written on the bag here. It's also in the bag's name. Basically, what Coleman have done, they've added an extra layer of insulation down in this foot section. Coleman claim it gives about 25% extra warmth in the foot area. Now, one of the reasons why that's pretty important is because some sleep studies show that women tend to have colder feet when they're sleeping. So a lot of women's specific bags will have that warmer section in the base. Now, on the end of the bag, we've got a couple of pieces of red paracord, and we've got a little instruction here. This is called the quick cord, and that essentially is a little cord system and a hook here. So when you're rolling up your sleeping bag, you can wrap this around the bundle and it keeps it all into place while you're trying to get it back into the bag. We also have what Coleman call a roll control system as well, which is these two little red toggles on this side of the sleeping bag, and they have corresponding red tabs on the opposite side. And what this means is that if you do choose to roll your sleeping bag away, if you're a roller and not a stuffer, you can fold your sleeping bag over like so, and the toggle and the tab will loop together, and that keeps your sleeping bag perfectly in alignment for when you want to roll it up. So whilst we're also on the red features of the Coleman sleeping bag, we also have this little red tab on our zip, which is called the ZipPlow. Now, this is on a couple of Coleman's sleeping bags, and basically it's just like a large plastic shield, which, as you can see, keeps that zip nice and wide and spread clear of excess fabric on the inside. And it means that the zip will just slide really easily up and down without getting any fabric bunched in on the back. Now, this sleeping bag, it does have a single zip. So one end starts up the top and it zips all the way down around the base of the foot in, as I said, a single zip. So the zip slider at the foot end, it doesn't have
the ZipPlow, but it does mean that you can, if you need to, if you're someone who does sleep with hot feet,
we can open up this sleeping bag at the base and that will give you a bit of ventilation down the bottom. And doing that now, we can also see this nice, lovely, soft, sort of lush fleece lining that's in the base of the foot here, which is different to that internal brushed polyester. So that's what's giving you a bit of extra warmth down the bottom. Now, being a single zip, I'm just gonna zip this one all the way up now. Being a single zip sleeping bag, you can still actually join one bag together with another to make it a double. What you do need to do is have the sleeping bag zipped up and then take the ZipPlow end of the zip, zip all the way down to the bottom. And from there, the zip itself will open up. So that means that we can use this sleeping bag right out flat like a quilt or a doona. But then if you do want to join those two bags together, what you're going to do is you're going to lay one open completely flat on the bottom, like so. And then you're going to open up your second bag in the same way, but you'll lay it on top like a sandwich. And from there, you'll be able to join the two zips together at the bottom in these two points and zip them around singularly up each side. The only consideration if you're doing that though and you're wanting to make it a double is that there is this small hood panel on the sleeping bag, which means you have the hood section on this side. Then if you're laying one on the top, it's going to be over this side as well. So I'm going to zip this bag back up together now because I want to get into it and show you how much room there is and give it a bit of a real life comfort test. But before I do that, I want to talk to you a little bit about the construction of the bag. So the actual stitching that you can see on the outside here, which is sort of like a nice contrasting lighter purple color, that stitching is actually going directly through the bag. So the stitching that you've got on the back here and the stitching you've got on the back, on the front here, it's the same line of stitching. So basically what that's doing is it's anchoring the insulation in place in these sort of long baffles. And that means that as you use the sleeping bag and over its age, the insulation's not going to be clumping or bunching or separating and creating cold spots in the bag. So getting into the bag itself, Coleman does say that the maximum user height for this sleeping bag is about 185 centimeters. So I'm 171, so I'm well within that height rating or height range there. And I can feel that ZipPlow's definitely helping me to zip that bag up without too much trouble. Just gonna snuggle into the bag like so. Now there is also an internal girth of about 160 centimeters of that bag, so it is quite roomy. I'll finish zipping it up all the way to the top here too, so I can feel how this sort of this draft collar here is nice and cozy. It does make you feel extra warm. Moving my feet around, I've got loads of room around my body, around my hips, down near my feet as well. I can feel that extra fleece and extra padding there. It feels a bit heavier on my feet, and I know it definitely instantly is feeling pretty warmer. The actual brushed polyester itself is really soft. I don't think you'd need to have a liner or a sheet or any other sort of anything on the inside of the sleeping bag here. It's quite comfy just against the skin that I can feel it on too. So I did mention before that the max user height is 185 and I'm 171 centimeters tall. Now I've positioned myself in this bag about where I'd want to be to be comfortable with the edge of the sleeping bag right up at my chin here to keep it all snuggly and warm. But in doing that, my feet are actually pushed quite up hard against the bottom of the bag and I can feel the zip there in between that sort of fleece lining. And I'd be sort of pretty concerned if I was much taller than that. If I wriggle a little bit further up and change my position in the bag and have this sort of draft collar a bit more near my chest, that does give me a bit more room on the foot, but I'm also feeling like that actually makes my head be exceeding the hood section that Coleman's got here on the sleeping bag. So I'd probably say being 171, you probably wouldn't want to be too much more than 175, I would say, to feel really comfortable and to fit really comfortably in this bag. So the benefit of this sleeping bag, as well as I mentioned earlier in the introduction, is that it's easy care, which means it's machine washable. The only consideration I'd want to make with that though is drying time and how heavy it's going to be when you are actually washing it, whether or not you can hang it up on a washing line and things like that. Now to pack it away, I'm just going to zip up either side of the sleeping bag, or sorry, this side of the sleeping bag. There's only one on this one, like so. Then what we're gonna do is, if you're wanting to do the rolling method, you're just gonna be folding it in half and locking up those little alignment tabs that keep you able to roll it up and nice and evenly. And then we're going to start. Now this end, which has the red paracord, that's the end that you need to leave free. So that paracord is open at the end for you to use it. So it would just be a matter of, and I'm just gonna do a rough demo here, rolling the sleeping bag up like so, which is quite huge, and grabbing your red paracord and wrapping it up like so. Now, obviously I've just done a bit of a rough go of that and the sleeping bag is very massive, but if you're doing it yourself at home, you're gonna put a lot more pressure into it. As I mentioned before, we do recommend doing the stuffing method. So jump to this link up here, which will give you a bit more of a rundown on how to do that. Some of the common feedback that we do have on this sleeping bag though, is that it is pretty tricky to get back into its original storage tag. If you're someone who's having that kind of trouble, you can get a separately available compression sack or sleeping bag compression sack from Cedar Summit. So the size that you'll need for this bag is an extra large. So this is called the Dry River compression sack, but it does come in a couple of different versions. As long as you get the extra large size, you should be completely fine. That's about it for the Coleman Aurora CO CozyFoot sleeping bag. You can get this at snowys.com.au at our lowest prices every day. If you found this video helpful, give us a like. If you've got any questions or comments, chuck them below. You can head here to subscribe or here for more helpful videos.